Welcome to the prologue.
Yeah. So, episode 77.
Yep.
Me and Matt recorded this for a minute, for 27 minutes.
Yes.
And about a half hour into our podcast, we realized that we weren't using the microphones. We were just talking into the laptop.
Yeah. So, Common mistake.
Pretty amateur mistake from my co-host here. He really shit the bed on this.
The sound guy fucked up,
dude. The sound guy shit the bed. But... What? How far in do you think it is? Like 27 minutes?
Literally 27 minutes.
So if you think, if the audio is too much for you...
If you're such a fucking pussy that you can't handle a little bit of change in audio, then just turn it off now forever.
True. But
yeah, it's 27 minutes and it's so fucking... We were going to delete it. Shane wanted to delete it and I was like, dude, it was so fun, dude. I was like, I got to give this to the people, dude.
True.
The people can handle it.
The episode, it was really funny and... we're back on our bullshit with the Asian voice. Heavy in this.
Yeah, heavy Asian voice. Yeah.
So enjoy the episodes.
Episode 77, wow. Dude, screaming out the gates.
You're fired up.
I'm so fucking fired up.
This is night and day that I'm dealing with.
I got food poisoning yesterday.
Yeah, from a gummy bear.
From a weed gummy.
we're late today because yesterday we tried to record a cast and it wasn't just you. The weed gummy had it in your mind that it was just you.
I was struggling, dude.
That was a bad game.
We both
didn't put it together.
Usually, like I said, usually I balance your negativity, and like the whole time I was more negative than you. See, like even that yesterday, I've been like, man, I gotta take it easy. He's not that negative. True. Now I'm like, yeah, he's that negative. But
yeah, that's what happens if I get weed gummy in me.
Well, it wasn't even I was negative. I was just on that. So I listened to Alex Jones all morning long, and I had this thing in my head. And I just nibbled on a weed, just a genuinely nibble on a weed gummy. No big deal. And as I'm on the way over here, and I'm like, what the fuck? And I'm like, I'll just pretend I'm Alex Jones the whole entire time. But I was doing his shit, like, word for word.
Yeah.
To where it was like, it made no sense other than me.
Yes.
To anyone other than me and my boy Spud, dude, because we watched the interview where he, like, went live and freaked out on Trump. It's just him being like, I shouldn't even be on air right now. I shouldn't be live.
No, I mean, you showed me as soon as you got in.
Yeah.
So other than you, me, and Spud.
It was just a three-way inside joke.
Like, all right.
That I was cracking up. In my head, I was laughing at myself the entire – I couldn't even look at Shane the whole time.
You could be like, I shouldn't even be on the air right now. I'd be like, yeah, I know, man. Well, how was your weekend? And you're like, I don't know about that. Like, all right.
Well, that theory actually – my brother watched – or he listened to that episode as well. Actually, this is funny because this ties into what I wanted to talk about. So I got a Lyft today, and my Lyft driver was a black dude, and we're talking. We're talking about – it's funny how, like, we started talking about girls, right, wearing – it was, like, warm out, and this one girl was wearing, like, just a T-shirt, and I'm like, dude, these girls don't – they, like, they want to dress slutty, dude, but it's, like, a little too cold. They're confused. And he's like, man, I saw some butt cheeks. So I'm like, dude – don't they understand, like, that's, like, a real physiological response? Like, my heart rate speeds up. And the guy's like, I know, man. And we start – that morphs into, like – we're talking. He goes, yeah, and pretty soon people are going to be like, oh, red light? That means go for me. And I'm like, what are you talking about, gender fluid, bruh? And he's like, what the hell is that? And I explained what gender fluid was to this guy. And he was just like, what the hell? And I'm like, dude, it's taught at college campuses. I'm telling all this shit. And he goes like this. He's like, do you listen to Alex Jones, bro? And I was like, yeah.
Black dude?
Yeah. He goes, bro, I fucking love Alex Jones. He was like, I ask every white person in here, I'm like, did you vote for Trump? He's like, bro, 50 million people voted for this motherfucker. I haven't had one say yes yet. Yeah. Dude, we start talking Trump. I'm telling him about Century of the Self. He's writing all this down. We had the best conversation ever. I just met my black brother in the Bizarro world, dude.
That's fucking
awesome. We had the same exact thoughts on everything.
Wow.
It was the best.
That's I'm really proud of you.
He was just like, dude, what the fuck did Trump even do? Like, he's done nothing. People are all mad at him. He's been in for 2 years. Dude, he was like, he's on the Trump train, dude. He doesn't give a fuck.
That's when you meet a black guy on the Trump train, that just means so much to me. It makes me so happy.
It was fucking sick because we had this it was almost like we're under, like, an oppressive regime. Like, we're kind of talking in code a little bit. And finally, I was like, bro, are you talking about this? And we go into it. And he was like, what the fuck? Dude, it was yeah. I was hitting him with shit of like where this stuff's going, the college campuses, and this guy was just like, holy fuck, man. He was blown away.
I mean, as cool as that is, it does, you know, that's a scary prospect that two people with the same, like, ideology have to, like, be, like, sneaking how to get into it to get, like, there's so much social pressure that yeah. neither of you can even bring up Donald Trump.
Yeah. Yeah, because he's like, I don't want to freak this out, this white guy about Donald yeah. Trump, and I'm, like, I'm basically explaining things to him about, like, how overeducated white people and like how like they're the ones who just I'm like they just use black people to like make themselves feel better and promote their own like and he was just like oh, but it was just shit
you're
like,
getting me going
it was just you're shit we were talking going. Dude they're just fucking elitist egalitarians dude who just stop at nothing to use other people to further their agendas and it was like I'm like going on and we're just slowly probing each other like is it cool to say this I didn't hit him with the black redneck theory yet I was like we just met I can't fucking hit him with this
yeah
but this guy would have been open he was open to everything dude we were talking
you told him about the podcast didn't you
I didn't tell him about the cast I didn't tell him I should have told him about the cast
I know
fuck
I was in a rush
you idiot I mean, you gave him the important.
I gave him the scoop.
The knowledge.
I know. I should have told him about the cast. I'm sure I'll see him again.
You think?
I'll see your Lyft driver again?
Dude,
our paths are meant to cross again, dude. This guy is the shit. It was my girlfriend called me while I was in the Lyft, and I was like, I gotta go. I can't talk. And then like she was like, what were you doing? I was like, I was talking to a black guy who listened to Alex Jones. I had to soak up every second of this. Dude, yeah. I think a lot of black – it's funny how he was like, you listen to Alex Jones, dude? I'm like, bro, did you hear that shit yesterday? And he was like, yo, bro, I'm telling you, man. They fucking cornered Trump, man. They got his lawyer's documents.
What kind of black guy was this? This is crazy.
Dude, this was a fucking like we had before, like our scale of like 1 to 5.
This is a solid 1.
So 1, Condoleezza Rice. 5 being like we said, just like fucking
5 is
clotheslining your fucking kid yeah. in the fucking candy aisle at Walmart. Yeah. This guy was a 3.5. This wasn't what? Like, yeah, man. This wasn't like, this was a no, by no means a black nerd. By oh, no means. Wow. This was like a 3. You get closer to the 5 range, bro. There's a lot there's of a lot cool of conspiracy theories. Yeah, man.
Yeah, you get close to the fucking black Muslims.
Yeah, dude.
Or not the black Muslims, the black Jews.
Oh, I mean, that's a whole... That's
when you start getting like...
That's level 10, dude. That's a whole other
that's
thing.
That's when they're like, yeah, white people are aliens. You get some conspiracy.
See, this guy was like... This dude was just kind of attuned to everything. And it was just funny to see... I was just like, thank God. I explained to him what a POC was. I was like, yeah, like I was like telling him, I was like, they went around and like these people were like giving hugs out the day after Trump won to like to black people. And they did it to my girlfriend. They were like, we just want to hug our POCs. And he was like, fuck's a POC? And I was like, it's a person of color.
Oh
I'm like,
God,
dude,
I'm like, dude,
think about this. This is their way of calling black people colored people again. He was like, dude, that's fucking bizarre. And I was like, tell me, bro. I'm like, shit's fucked up.
You tell me, bro. I'm telling you.
But yeah, that
what
was
what I've been saying.
I was absolutely, I'm telling you. I was absolutely, yeah, you said it, not me, dude. Yeah,
I'm telling you.
I was so fucking stoked. It was awesome.
That's really great.
Man, I've been turbocharged today, dude. I woke up at 6 a.m. My girlfriend didn't have to get up for work till like 10
you've
o'clock.
You've been up since 6 a.m.
Bro, 6 o'clock over dot.
That means you've been awake for 6 hours longer than me today. it's 12:40. I've had a whole day.
Yeah. She usually gets up at 5:30, so like she for some reason didn't have to go until like 10.
Yeah.
So her alarm went off at 5 o'clock. I like laid there for a little bit and then I fell back. I had a dream that you and I actually, oh, dude, this is fucked Christ, up. Dude. This was really fucked up.
You always have dreams.
You were in this one.
All
right. Dude, so I swear on my fucking life I'm not embellishing this. So there was this guy, it was my aunt's house. This is where it's all taking place. But there's a guy who lived there. Never seen this man in my life who had a fetish for like beating the shit out of his balls. So this guy, it's like the first part of the dream is just a guy walking out of his house with like a vice grip around his nuts and just punching them He's walking down the street. And then me and you were sitting there and I was like, yo, let's go into his house. Let's go look for all of his weird shit he has in here. So we went into this guy's house.
In your dream, I said yes to that?
Yeah, you came with me. And then there was like a weird aspect to like, to make the long story short, the guy ended up coming back. So like this dude, the guy who's abusing his balls is outside of the house and we're in there. And I'm like, dude, we got to get the fuck out of here. And Sonia came in at one point. And Sonia's in the dream. And we're like, I got to get in. And I'm like, I had to like put my jacket back on and all this stuff. So I jumped out the window and turns out he's having a big party that like my whole family's invited to. So I go outside and then I realize I like left some shit in there, like my keys or something. And I see my whole family and the ball guy's like, "Hey, were you in my house?" And I woke up and I was like, "Holy shit, dude." So.
Stop. I love hearing your dreams.
Yeah.
But you always expect like a response.
I don't expect a response.
But you tell me it's gibberish. Just a dream, dude. Dreams are not meant to be shared.
Yeah, they are.
No, they make no sense.
Dude, they do.
So, like, you finish this. That probably had a profound effect on you, that dream, because you were in it.
You were in it, too.
But that has nothing to, like, I can't.
I thought I forgot my wallet in this house. And he's like, "Nah, dude, you knew where all my stuff was." You're like, "No, your wallet's in your jacket pocket." I'm like, "Thanks, dude." It was a fucking, I thought it was an interesting dream.
I had a dream where I fucked some lady last night.
Really?
Yeah.
It's a mystery woman.
And then I woke up and I couldn't remember who it was.
Sometimes they're just mystery people.
That's because I jerked off before bed.
You did?
Right before bed and went to sleep. I think I had some residue still left in the chamber. Got me fired up.
You had a Wetster?
No, I didn't nut again.
If you nocturnally nut, it's cheating.
No, it's not.
It's not cheating unless you nut. If you have a wet dream.
True.
Too bad.
Wet dream.
It's done, dude.
Well, my girlfriend's going to be very upset about that.
Everyone has weird sex dreams.
Yeah, I know.
I kind of had one last night.
Yeah, true.
That guy beating his balls.
Punching his own balls.
Yeah. You know what's funny, though? Because I started a new practice last night where, dude, I can get through the day without fapping. When the sun's up, I'm good. It's when the night falls, my girlfriend goes to sleep an hour and a half before me. That's when all the fucking sprites and fairies come out in my little fap fantasy land, dude. And I'm like, so I fell off the train, dude. I fucking.
Wait, when?
Dude, like. The last 3 days.
You jerked off the last 3 days?
Just pulling pure shower imaginations, dude. I know. Imaginations.
No.
I started carb cycling, dude. I need an outlet. I'm
three
fucking...
straight days you've been jerking off in the shower?
Yes, it was. It was three straight nights. And I was like, something has to give, dude. So maybe I'm not falling back into this.
Maybe that man punching himself in the balls was kind of a...
It's me in the shower, dude.
Self-loathing...
Could be, dude. And that's what I'm saying. But so I started doing a thing last night where as soon as the night falls, dude, and my fap little fap demons come out,
yeah.
I just do an hour-long meditation before bed now.
Okay.
So I just close my eyes, put on the binaural theta waves, dude, and I just fucking rock out.
Okay.
And I get to do it, and it's like by that time, I'm like, all right, time to go to bed. I did it for an hour last night. And then I researched about like – if you meditate for an hour, you start half kind of falling asleep, and it's really, really weird.
Yeah.
And I started, like, Googling about people seeing weird shit when they meditate. And this one guy was saying that, like, a very small percentage of people actually develop psychosis from meditating. Which is so funny to think of someone starting to meditate and just going schizophrenic and being like, what happened? Like, he started meditating, dude, and he fucking freaked.
That is crazy.
That's nuts.
That is. Wow. The power of the mind.
Whoa. I know.
Whoa.
Exactly. Well, it's somewhere in there, and you're like, and all of a sudden you're like, I'm going to kill everybody.
Oh, fuck, I'm retarded.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I dreamt of banging some lady. But I'll tell you how I really screwed up is my bae, she's said she's been feeling stressed lately. She's having a rough week.
Yeah.
The weather's not helping. You know, it's been raining. It's It's cold again.
Mm-hmm.
She sent me this nice long text message before bed, and it was like, write me something back so I can read it in the morning when I wake up before school, and I'll have a better day.
Yeah, nice.
And so I fell asleep without sending anything.
Oh, man.
And then so I woke up this morning at like, well, today at like noon. I woke up at like 11 with a text that was like, nice, thank you. I was just like, fuck.
Hey,
so she got a lunchtime message. I sent her a nice message.
Your lunch is going to be great, babe.
I love you. You're so smart and sweet and beautiful. I had to throw one together real quick. I was like, it means so much to me that I love you so much.
Yeah, that's what Brittany used to do. She would do that for me. If I had like anything important, like a show, it would be like a long, like she always remembered like – it was almost like uncanny. Like right before I go on stage, like, you're the best. You're going to do so well. Blah, blah, blah. And if she has like – she has, like, really important shit to do. She would come home, and I'm like, how was today? She's like, I did the bow. I'm like, Oh yeah, fuck, forgot about that. I'm like, you're the best, babe. You're gonna kill it. She's like, I told you 10 times. I'm like, yeah, I'm sorry. I totally forgot.
Yeah, and also, I do believe, I think my girlfriend can lie and get away with it when it comes to like, yeah, I told you I was doing that today. Or like, if I'm like, yeah, I have a show this weekend. I told you that. She's like, no, you didn't.
Oh, dude.
And I'm like, okay.
Fuck, that pisses me off.
She's right every time on that because my memory is.
There's no way you can put yourself. Dog shit. Yeah, there's no way you can put yourself. Well, I had to do something Sunday. I told her like 5 times this Sunday for the Gerbys thing. I'm like, I got to do it. It got canceled. And I'm like, it's coming up.
This Sunday?
Yeah. I was like, it's coming up, blah, 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 blah. Then today she sent me a thing for like a fucking science fair or some shit. It's like an adult science fair thing. Just an onslaught of bullshit. So I see that and I'm like.
Adult science fair? I'd rather watch Natasha Leggero and Moshe Kasher's Netflix.
Fuck them, dude.
Yeah, dude.
That is, dude, if you don't know what we're talking about, it's basically, it's as if I were to agree to go to the science fair, but put that on the level of a Netflix special. When your girlfriend's like, we should do one together when I'm pregnant. And you're such a bitch. You're like, yeah, I'll tie my comedy career to your thing and act like you're my boss.
Yeah.
Like, dude. And dude, what an unoriginal bullshit trope of like, I'm the idiot husband and you're the smart one. Yep. Oh, it's like, come on, dude.
She's the diva, and I'm just, just a cock husband that's just kind of a pussy.
It used to be, like, the dumb husband stereotype of, like, Homer Simpson beer drinking. Now it's, like, the over-educated liberal cuck. Like, yeah, babe, whatever. It's like, ew, dude.
I like Homer Simpson, dude.
I much prefer Homer Simpson,
because that's what my dad was like.
I mean, dude, if I was Moshe, I was telling you, I wouldn't let my wife do stand-up while she's pregnant.
You gotta check your bitch.
I don't want her fucking raising her blood pressure and getting all fucking adrenaline. It's like, nah, dude.
If my bitch is pregnant, you're bedridden for 9 months.
You're in a straw hut drinking milk, dude.
Yes, I'm gonna get you the finest.
Surrounded by my other wives, dude.
The goat's milk. Strength to raise a strong boy.
Dude, Shane showed me like 3 minutes of that, and it was just like.
That's about as far as I got.
God damn it, it was bad.
So her opening joke goes like, she's like, so yes, I'm pregnant. Don't clap too hard. I'm still in the abortion phase.
Yuck.
I might get one. Depends on how you guys do as a crowd. But she opens with a sick abortion joke, which is tight as fuck.
So powerful.
I feel like women that are edgy don't do that enough. And then, my jokes are all sick. This isn't about me.
Nah, dude. No one's treading your ground, dude. No one's
treading your ground. Don't fucking tread on my material, dude.
No one's treading on your
ground. Retarded people are funny. That's my direct. What was it? It was like abortion into. She's like classic misdirection. She's like, it's so powerful to have a human. Like, I'm creating life in my body. And also, I don't want to get too choked up when I say this, but. It's going to be 5 months until I can do another drug.
Ugh.
And she's like, what if I just took a toke and, like, the baby was a little fucked up?
A little glitchy.
A little glitchy. And she's like, the bar has been set so low that even if it was a little messed up, it could still become president of the United States.
Ugh.
Unless it's a girl. It's like, damn, she even capped it off with sexism.
I remember that was... 3 minutes and 42 seconds into it, she covered all the ground of hacky female comedy.
Abortion. Trump.
Yep.
I love drugs.
I'm an alcoholic. I have a drinking problem.
Sorry, I love vodka and weed. Sorry.
Hello, vodka. It's me, Chelsea Hanna. Dude, it's so shitty. It sucks, too, to like – if you watch, she is – she has like a fur jacket on. She's trying to like personify something. It's like you're not being a real person.
Yeah, I know.
You're being a fake, weird thing, and it's like – it sucks because if you're dumb enough, you're like, oh, my God, yeah, this is great. But if you're like just a smidge smarter than that, you're like, this is all bullshit. This is stupid.
I see right
fucking through. You're trying to say what – like who should have been president besides Trump? Fucking leader of the Clinton crime family, bro? Get the fuck out of here.
Oh, man.
Empress.
Every time I shit on a comic on here – I usually feel bad, but we do have a decent lineup of comics we've shit on.
Yeah.
Got like Hasan Minhaj,
True Play. I still think about fucking every time I walk listening to rap, I just think about my entrance music just fucking coming down and beating his ass. I want him to take. I'm gonna fight him, dude.
You're gonna beat up Hisamana.
I wanna do like a celebrity boxing match thing, but just like for charity. But they, I'm a nobody. That's one of my main day, like just daydreams, is beating the fuck
beating
out of
the
him.
Shit out of Hisamana.
It's like, dude, you're a pussy. I just want them to know that. Be like, I'm a huge pussy. I'm not cool. I'm not tough.
Yeah.
He's a fucking bitch, dude.
Yeah.
Like it just pisses me off, dude. I hate that. Sorry. I hate that.
Real articulate take.
Hey.
Like, no, I wanted to know he's not fucking tough, dude. I'll fuck him up.
I hate him.
He's gay, and I hate him.
I didn't say he's gay. I just hate that thing about his dad beating him. I'm like, you shut the fuck up, dude.
Yeah,
bitch fucking dad.
He's like, white people, you don't understand what it's like to be hit. Brown people, am I right? Brown people? It's like, dude, stop trying to be black, you fucking Asian.
Yeah, exactly.
You're from the Orient. Act like it.
I don't mean to fucking burst your bubble, bro, but I'm cooler than you. I don't see, like, I'll see, like, black dudes, like, damn, what are they doing? That's cool. I never see an Indian guy, like, what are those cool motherfuckers up to? Yeah, I'm just like, sup, nerds?
Oh, man. What are those, joggers?
Yeah, what's up, slightly less nerd than fucking hardcore Asian dudes? It's like, how you doing?
Real.
And that's how it goes, bro. I didn't write these rules.
I didn't write the rules either.
I didn't dig the river, bro. I'm swimming in.
That's true. That's what you're raging against when you see, because especially we've covered this a million times, but Drexel's campus.
Oh my god.
Top to bottom, cool Asians.
Yeah, dude.
We're not talking. Well, you can tell the foreign exchange Asians.
Yeah.
They're fucking. They're dressed like, I don't know, man. I don't know what the fuck. They're dressed like, what was that? It's just like you ever see that bear that's like a logo for something?
I think I know what you're talking about. Well, you can tell, like a fresh off the boat Asian, it's just the level of nerd they're comfortable with displaying personally is just like, holy fuck, dude. Like your pants are up to your nipples, dude, and you are still like smiling.
It's like they Googled like, what is an an outfit?
Yeah.
And they're just trying clothes. They're literally just trying clothes on for the first time. Like trying to pass it off, which those guys are great.
Great.
Give me some Asians. Give me some fresh.
I like cool Asians in the gym because I love seeing them in there getting jacked. I steal some of those Asian secrets, dude.
Like what?
They squat with their shoes off.
What?
I pop my shoes off. I totally fucking Last Samurai that. I white appropriated their Asian fucking secrets, which is like a bodybuilding secret. But I just saw an Asian guy doing it, and I was like, man, you guys know so much about fucking secret health stuff, dude.
So now you don't wear shoes and you do squats?
When I squat, I take my shoes off. I do it with my socks.
Oh, my God. You fucking suck, too, dude. You suck, too.
If I see someone do something cool in the gym, I wait till they leave and I instantly copy it. This one guy did this thing where he puts his, a barbell bench thing where it goes up and down. He puts his feet on it and then puts two dumbbells and holds himself on dumbbells and does push-ups. And I, like, watched this guy do this. And as soon as he left the building, I was like, I'm doing that shit right now, dude.
I can't. Dude, I forgot that. I wanted to say this. I was talking. So I watched that sick-ass movie, Patriots Day.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It gets me going, dude. I love this country so much.
Dude, you should.
But they mess with the wrong city. Let me tell you that.
Why?
The Zarnav brothers, they messed with the wrong city. They messed with Boston, and we were trying to jog, and they blew it up and ruined it. You fucking gay Muslim faggots.
We paid money to We paid $85 to run in a circle, and bombed it.
And you bombed it, and you blew off a bunch of hot chicks' legs, and I don't like that.
That's what you said. They blew up shrapnel.
Yeah, it was all low. They put the bombs on the ground.
What dick bomb.
It ended up blowing people's legs off.
That's a really dick bomb, dude.
It hit kids and legs.
God.
But, the one kid, and I forgot about it, one of the main parts of the story is this Asian kid. They carjacked an Asian dude.
Wait, what?
When they were running away in the middle of the night. There was a manhunt for like several
days. Yeah, yeah. They carjacked an Asian dude?
They carjacked an Asian.
Fast and Furious car?
No.
Okay.
He's super Asian from China. Sick ass scene where these two Muslim dudes that are acting black get in. And are trying to carjack this Asian dude. And he's like, I don't want any problems with you, please. And they're like, who cares about you in this country? Who do you have that cares about you? He's like, nobody care about me here. Because
did they recruit him?
His family's all in China. So he's sitting in the car and he's like, please, take everything. Just leave me alone, please. And they're like, do you know 9/11 was an inside job? And he's like, I don't know much about the 9/11. And they're like, yeah, that's because you're fucking brainwashed, dude. 9/11 was an inside job. And he's like, oh, okay. Okay, please. Dude, it's so funny.
That's the highest comedy ever.
It really is the best comedy. And then he...
What if you found out Mark Wahlberg, Tyler Perry, that whole situation? That was just Mark Wahlberg him. Playing the Asian.
It was Jin Yang from Silicon
was
Valley.
Was it really?
Yeah. He's Holy so fucking fuck. Good. He's great. But that Chinaman ended up escaping their car and running and calling the police on them.
He called the police.
He broke it, which is another great scene. Because then he breaks into – he's at a gas station. They're at a gas station. He escapes his captors, retarded Zarnia brothers. They fucking suck so bad. They were so fucking gay. But then Jin Yang runs out to another gas station, which of course is owned by an Arab. So he comes in. He's like,
help!
I need your help. There are a kidnapper me over there. And the Arab's like, buddy. Two dudes just trying to speak English. Trying to solve a crisis.
The funniest part is how that movie's based off of real events. So at one point, a real Asian guy got like interrogated by the FBI, and he's like, "Oh, they tell me 9/11 is not real." And they're like, "Wait, what? Yeah, is that inside job?"
They are very angry because 9/11 was very inside the jokes. Very inside the jokes. The fucking there's security footage of it too, so you can see this Arab dude who owns this gas station, like, trying to tell him to be quiet. And it's a college student, Asian kid, who's so like traumatized from this that he like crawls into the gas station and like hides behind the shit, like in the desk.
Holy shit!
And this guy's like, "I have a man in here. I can't." He's like, "He's not speaking English very good." Asian kid gets on. He's like, "We need help here." And the cops are like, "What the fuck is this phone call?"
Dude, that's the funniest fucking thing in the world.
Oh my god,
I'm fucking crying.
That Patriots Day is great.
I gotta watch that.
Great movie.
I gotta fucking watch that.
And there's one part where Wahlberg, they have this, the FBI and the Boston PD, dude, don't fucking mess
Boston's
with
finest,
the
dude.
PD, dude, they're so strong.
They hate bombs, dude.
I hate bombs. But they mess with the wrong city.
Oh my god.
They recreate the crime scene in the warehouse. And they're like, "We need to figure out which security cameras that we'll be able to see these guys on."
Yeah.
So, like, who knows these streets better than anybody? And Mark Wahlberg steps up. He's like, "At 5:42, they might have been out front of the Crate and Barrel right here." And he's like, think, man. It's crazy.
They're outside of Wahlburgers, and they made a left and hit the other Wahlburgers on the north side.
Sweet.
Oh, and at one point, that was Donnie Wahlberg. It was an Entourage. I was about to say Mark Wahlberg was like, "I love this city." And I'm like, "Wait, that's Entourage, that's his brother."
No, he was.
Was Mark? Did Mark grace fucking Entourage?
I think Mark Wahlberg was like the executive producer of.
Was it? Oh, Entourage. That was like based on his life, right?
Yeah.
Shit.
Who the fuck knows? That shit's all corny.
Dude, the boys, dude. What do you know about checking in on Turtle and the gang?
Entourage really sucked.
That was the worst show that I, like, couldn't stop watching. Even, like, I was done it, digested it. I was like, this shit sucks so bad.
Oh, no.
Oh, dude. Oh, my God. Fuck. We're live. We're back. I fucked up because I'm a fucking loser, dude. I didn't have the audio thing plugged into my thing. We were recording the last 27 minutes straight through my laptop, so the audio is a little tinny.
Yeah, the audio sucks dick, but don't worry.
I know our fucking fans will be with us, dude. They wouldn't want that deleted, dude.
I wanted to delete it, Matt.
It was too good. I was having too much of a good time.
Matt stood his ground.
I fucking stood my ground.
I tried
dude.
To fucking sneak through his private neighborhood. And Matt stood his ground. He said, "You get out of my property."
I couldn't, dude. I couldn't.
Not
I
thought even of, my property.
I thought
my
about
neighbors.
The boys, dude, and I was like, I can't fucking do it. Sorry about the quality for the first 27 minutes. That was my bad.
Mm-hmm.
My bad.
I heard that.
God damn it, man. I was just too fucking funny about those two dudes trying to sort out a terroristic threat.
Asian men.
You speak English, buddy.
Yeah.
I don't speak English.
Yeah, over there. The terrorists. Very right there.
And the guy at the gas station is like, don't call them terrorists.
Oh, yeah, true.
That'd be funny. Oh, wait, so you think they're terrorists? Like, no, they actually blew people's legs off. Oh, okay.
Oh, it's another great part. As soon Mark Wahlberg, of course, goes to meet the Asian man at the gas station, the Asian boy who was heroically escaped, and he's like, "What?" He's like, "Wait, they told you they were the marathon bombers?" And he's like, "Yes, and they also are using my GPS, which tracking number is 3, 7, 5, 8, 6, 2, 7. And he's like, "How do you know that?" He's like, "I don't know. I just know it."
What?
Yeah, it's classic Asian.
Holy shit,
dude. He was an autistic the whole time, and you can't tell because he's Asian.
Really?
Really?
And he got abducted by the fucking Indian Silent Bob and Jay and Silent Bob. He's like, dude. Yeah.
Not Indian. Basically Russian, dude.
Oh, you told me that. They were like fucking...
Chechenian, Dagestani.
Well, I sound like an ass.
Why?
Were they like Middle Eastern at all?
No.
Give me something, dude. They're just white guys?
No, they're like
they're white guys?
Weird Russian different.
I stereotyped, dude. I stereotyped that they'd be Middle Eastern. I was saying they're like Middle Easterners.
No.
Sorry, guys. Sorry, listeners.
No, well, they're different. They're different than us. I'll tell you that. So I don't like them. They don't look like us, dude.
Oh, my God. Oh, dude. So from doing all like the Craigslist stuff, when I finished doing that book, I went on Craigslist and started just trying to like promote it and like the writing subs and stuff. So now I've been having, one person now who's been sending me like their feedback. The guy I argued with basically, who was talking shit and being all negative. He's like, "Well, can I send you?" We like talked and he was like, "Can I send you some stuff I've been working on? There's something wrong with it. I can't figure it out." So he sends me this short story he did. So I'm reading it and I'm like, you know, there was something he was doing that was wrong that I told him. I'm like, just like sentence wise, I was like, this is kind of fucked up. But I kept reading. It wasn't bad. He's a good writer. But the story was about this fucking like young teenage boy who was attracted to his little brother's prepubescent friend. So like I'm in page 3 before like the story starts. And I don't know anything about the story. So I'm reading it. And it's like, and then like the friend comes in. And I touched the back of his hair and let him in. And it's like, my mom's not looking. And I love when she gives us these moments. And I'm like, what the fuck is this? And slowly the story takes shape. Like, he's trying to fuck this boy. And I'm like, what the hell? So it's a guy with his little brother's friend. The little brother's sick in bed. And the guy's supposed to take them out to go, like, hunting for bugs. But since the little brother's sick, he finally gets this little boy all to himself. Dude, I'm like reading the story like, dude. And he's like... I don't know what doesn't work with it. I'm like, maybe it's a fucking pedophile tale, bro. And it's like, but the writing itself was fucking, it was good. The descriptions were good and everything. So the whole story basically is like, they go outside, they go to this mountain, they're looking for bugs and stuff. They find a wounded bird. And the whole time this guy is like, how can I like make a move? This is so, how do I make a move? But they never clarify how old the older kid was. Just said he had pubes. The other one didn't. Get it? So you're with me, but it's like they go to the top of this big, like mountainous type hill, and he's like, oh, I know what I'll do. He tells the kid, he's like, maybe we should pee off the mountain, right? He's like, do you ever take a pee off a mountain? He's like, that way both their dicks were out. And the kid was like, I guess I'll do it. So like they're both peeing off the mountain, and he was like, do you know how to get all your pee out? And the kid's like, yeah, I just shake it. And he goes, no, there's a trick. You push your taint. And the kid's like, what's my taint? And he goes, here. And he touched the kid's taint. And the little boy ran away screaming. As he runs away down the hill, he tumbles and falls and basically like dies. I was reading this like, this is so fucked up. That's the most fucked up story I've ever read. I was like, dude, what the fuck, man?
Yeah.
And I had to email him back like, yeah, your descriptions were good, I guess. I'm like, I don't know, man. And I don't want to square out on a subject matter. It's like, you know, follow the muse to wherever it takes you. But it's like...
That's going to be a tough sell.
Bro, that was oddly specific. And I'm like, you really nailed the mentality of a guy wanting to fuck a kid better than anyone I've ever seen.
Yeah.
It was fucking weird, dude.
Yeah, well, that explains why he was criticizing people's books on Reddit.
Yeah.
Not like famous books. He's just shitting on.
He's being a dick. That's what I said. I'm like, were you
strangers' books,
dude? I'm like, are you just being a dick to be a dick? And he was like, no, I'm sorry. He was just a
pedophile,
dude. That was fucking crazy, man.
Yeah, he ran into a pedophile. He emailed you his book. You might want to contact somebody.
I don't think he's in England.
It's out of my. I should go Mark Wahlberg, England, and be like, where's this fucking guy?
He tried to rape my tent in the woods.
He tried to rape me. It says that 9/11 is not real.
Oh, dude. I can't get it out of my head what this is going to sound like.
What?
Hit pause real quick.
What? You boy, we're back.
Yeah, sorry. I couldn't get it out of my head.
The sound quality issue was just fucking Shane up.
It was stuck in my crawl.
You're where?
My crawl.
Your crawl?
Crawl.
A little crawl space?
No.
Oh.
Like C-R-A-W.
Okay. Right? I got you.
You ever hear that saying?
I think I did. I don't know. It sounds familiar
enough.
I'm
hesitant.
It sounds like a nice southern saying. Like, stuck in my crawl.
Yeah, it was stuck up there.
I feel it in my crawl. Right in
it was in my crawl so hard. But yeah, I just wanted to double check. What the fuck were we talking about?
I saw you go elsewhere when I was talking about the child molester that sent me his short story.
Oh, yeah.
His autobiography, dude.
Yeah, I should have been all over that.
The fact that the kid tried to run away and died, I was like, Jesus, fuck, man. Then it just ends.
Yeah, well, that's a pedophile who's... I mean, it's better than fucking kids, but
true that. I mean, I was reading at one point, it was just like, I felt like I was reading like... pedophile erotica. I was like, what the fuck, dude?
I guess it's like
that little boy was so hot to him, dude.
Like, is Stephen King a murderer?
That's what I'm saying.
So it's like, I mean, I guess you can write this stuff.
I want it to be like, bro, why the fuck are you writing about a guy who wants to fuck a little boy? But it's like, man, I'd hate for someone to be like, don't write about that. So I'm like, hey, man, you know, you put the incline on 50 on that. You know, if that's what you want to write about, if you want to be like the fucking, if you want to be the J.K. Rowling's of like pedophilia, it's like, hey, bro, that's a heavy cross to try to trudge up the hill of mud. No, there's not a market for that.
There's quite the market.
Actually, yeah, that's true. That's,
pretty big market.
I wonder if it's like a loophole, like a little like child porn loophole to be like, no, it's literature.
True.
They never got away.
True. Yeah, I guess you could write child.
And I'm like sitting here correcting it, like, hey, dude, don't blend in your descriptions with actions, dude. Come on, man.
Yeah, you're going to be brought into this child.
I know.
Yeah, you might not want to email this guy back.
I got hijacked, dude.
What's his email?
I forget. It's in my email address. I'm going to give him up to the feds, dude. Yeah. I'm going to call Mark Wahlberg, dude. I got to let
him
know.
Call Wahlberg.
I'll be like, Wahlberg, I got a situation. You got to fly to London. The big in Ocean's 11.
That'd be nice.
I'm on it.
He's going to get him.
Yeah.
That's an odd loophole. Can you write child porn? I think you can.
Yeah, man. I mean, you can get as gross as you want.
That's victimless. Child porn is not illegal because it's gross. It's illegal because it's hurting a kid.
True that, actually. Well... There
but
it is.
My take on child porn is if the kid's already been damaged, you might as well get some nuts out of this.
You think so?
I think people should be able to jerk off to child. No, of course not.
I told you my idea before, right?
What's that?
Child porn, but shot and directed by kids. That way they get all the money.
All right. Now.
Porn for kids, by kids, baby. Let's do it.
This is a topic that I'm starting to. It's even when I was saying my take on it, I was
it's a horrible thing.
This isn't even funny.
We're kidding, bro. We're in jest.
We're just kidding.
We're in jest, dude.
Oh, we're kidding,
dude. Actually, I came across a situation on Reddit that I thought was very interesting. So it was a girl updating people in like the relationship subreddit to something that happened with her boyfriend. They wanted to do threesomes, right? Dig this, dude. This, I still don't know where I stand on this. So this girl, she and her boyfriend talked and like, you know, they want to get into doing threesomes and stuff. So who does she, I'm thinking female, female, male. The first threesome they do, bro, it's male, male, female. With none other than this dude's fucking best dog, who they call Jack, quote unquote.
Yeah.
And the guy was, she was like updating him because like, I think she'd written a thing before because the guy had gotten, her boyfriend had gotten like real insecure because Jack apparently has like a fucking big donger and is like, she was like, he's just stronger than my boyfriend. He's bigger down there, if you know what I'm saying. And then I enjoyed, like, he's never seen me enjoying sex like that.
Oh,
he was
my
saying,
God.
Bro, it's mind melting. I'm like reading this, like, this is so fucked up. And she picked his best fucking friend. And she's like, and, you know, I kind of had a crush on him. I used to joke about this. I'm like, you just figured out a way to fuck your boyfriend's best friend with a huge dong.
Yeah.
With him in there.
That's scary.
This guy was fucked up. And then So they did it again. Eventually, you know, he's like, I don't think he talks to Jack anymore, but they, Jack just wandered off. So then they had one where it was female, female, male. And he said, she was like, well, the girl had like a big bubble butt. I know he likes that. So I kind of know what he's feeling. It's like, no, the fuck you don't, dude. No, you don't. Chicks can't be cuckolded, dude. They don't have that fucking, that part of jealousy to where like, this guy's going to fucking impregnate. You know what I mean? It's like, I think girls can get jealous, but I don't think they can feel the cuckold rage, dude.
I don't know, but I do hate.
They can be insecure.
I really hate when people are like, yeah, I'm like pretty poly. Like, I'm very open sexually. It's like, I bet you're not.
Well, here and here.
I bet when push comes to shove, you get pretty angry.
Well, herein lies the problem, though. Apparently, according to this girl, now it's like a weekly tradition, though. Now they have threesomes. So Jack's got a fucking jackhammer your girl in front of you, but then every week you're having a threesome. But she alternates MMF, FFM every other week.
Yeah, that's a terrible relationship.
Isn't that fucked up?
That's a bad, you're not together. You're just, now you're a swinger.
Pretty much, yeah, you're right.
You're just like.
But it's like one-on-one thing where it's like this, I mean, and she even said, she was like, yeah, you know, like doing like a male-male, female threesome, I enjoyed it, but it really takes a physical toll on me. And I'm reading this as like, I don't even know this girl. And I'm like, kid, fucking God, lady.
Yeah, she's probably a fucking piece of shit.
Jesus, man.
Probably a gross whore. I don't like it.
Dude, I was, in my head, I'm like, but you get to have a threesome every other week. That's pretty fucking tight. But like, can you even enjoy a threesome after Jack fucking just absolutely dominated your girlfriend in front of you, dude?
Yeah.
Your best friend fucks your girlfriend better than you can ever imagine and then just stops being your best friend.
Yeah.
And people are like cheering her on. I'm like, dude, this is fucking horrible. Why'd you pick this guy's best friend?
Dude, I don't fuck with those on Reddit. There's like,
I love reading them, dude.
There's like stories on there of like, there's one that's like the feminist one. I think it's, what's it? 2X chromosomes?
I think so, yeah.
Is that what it is be a female?
I think so, yeah.
One of them's Down syndrome and
one of them's retarded. Of them's, I don't
like,
know.
An
yeah.
Extra chromosome. But, it's all like
that's
females.
That's what fucking Vin Diesel's triple X is about. Yeah, dude.
He's actually got Down syndrome. Yeah. He's driving cars too fast.
Your cars are faster. I live my life 1/4 mile at a time.
Retarded and furious, dude.
But it's chicks like cheering each other on for having abortions.
Yeah.
And it weirds me out. It's like, I do understand the point of like people needing support who go through
for sure,
that.
Cause yeah.
Obviously it's a fucking traumatic experience, yeah. But then sometimes chicks will get on and be like, no, I didn't give a fuck at all. And I'll be sitting there like, this is,
they probably
didn't. And
they're
all, cause all right. So if you're getting on Reddit and messaging in a feminist blog, chances are you have the financial means to raise a kid. If you're that much of like a
push
woke,
came to sh- if push
if
came
woke
to shove
feminist, if you're a woke feminist,
yeah,
you probably came from a pretty privileged life.
You're a phone call away. You're like an uncomfortable phone call away from having like a sick setup for your kid.
You become a woke feminist by going to college.
Yeah.
So,
yeah,
you had enough money to go to fucking
at least
Susquehanna University.
You can comfortably say at least 85% of these chicks can fully, yes.
Sure. So these are all just abortions that are like, I wanted to pursue my life and dreams, so I couldn't, I had to abort this baby. And they're like, you go, girl, get rid of that fucking baby.
Ew, man.
I'm like,
I don't read that. I read relationships.
I'm like, should I be?
You should.
It's like the liberal, the correct progressive thing to be like, yeah, it's your body, girl. If you want to keep being an improv chick, then yes.
Yeah, I don't think it's anything
terminate
to
that life.
Ew, dude, I just don't think it's anything to be celebrated.
Yeah,
I would
never
be like I think girls should definitely be able to choose, but it's like, and don't be out here bragging about that shit, man. It's fucked up. And I hear that, dude, and I'm like, ew, man. But there are, dude, there's definitely girls way cold enough to be like, yeah, I'd fucking get it out of me. But a lot of them, dude, I think in their darkest hour, dude, they fucking think about that little toddler, dude, and they're just
whoa, slow down, dude. This is.
I'm just saying, when the fucking, you know, when the head hits the pillow,
yeah,
dude,
staring at the
and all the fucking Justins and Jasons are gone, dude, and you're just laying there and you think about little Xavier, dude. His
party
little,
time's over.
His little tadpole body, dude. You're like.
When UCB when UCB cuts you, you're like, you're not that funny, and you're laying staring at the ceiling just like, oh, fuck.
You have like an Old Testament biblical family of dead babies hovering about and haunting your fucking room. You're just like, I mean, like, that's a fucking heavy load.
Maybe they do improv with their aborted babies, ghosts, in the middle of the night. They're like, yes, and they're like, why would you kill us? She's like, I'm an airplane. I'm on an airplane. What? What did you say?
I mean, then you just grab a couple cats, dude, and ride off into the sunset. You're just like, yeah, I had a shot at this.
That's pretty sick. Maybe she performs for the aborted fetuses every night. And she's like, any suggestions? And they're like, please stop killing us. And she's like, oh, nope. What was that? Did somebody say, I'm in a grocery store? And they're like, no, please, no more abortions, oh my God, mom. Dude.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. So, but here's one that fucked me up. This is a story that I'm just ripping from another podcast. This was on Legion of Skanks brought this up.
Yeah.
And the first time I heard it, I was driving, and this affected me. I don't know if I told you this. You know the movie Milo and Otis? Mm. All right, so it was like my favorite movie as a little kid. It's about a pug puppy and a kitten.
Sounds great.
Yeah, and it's just a British voiceover, a narrator, and this pug puppy and a kitten are on this magical adventure. And it turns out, did you just fart?
No, I scratched a chair. Oh.
it turns out that, like, there's one scene where they're both in a box going down a river.
Uh-huh.
And then there's one scene where the kitten's about to get attacked by a bear and the pug chases it away.
Sounds great.
This is all real animals.
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
this
of
isn't
course.
Like a cartoon.
I love those movies, dude. Air Bud.
Except the news that I was told by Legion of Skanks podcast was that these animals were all expendable and they died.
Wait.
Like, they had like 30 pug puppies.
Stop,
to
dude.
Play Milo and Otis.
No, how old is this movie?
It's old. It's from like the 80s.
How the fuck? Oh, okay. I guess they could get away
with
that.
I think it was
that.
Made by the Japanese.
No, dude.
Yes, dude. So they were just like, I throw the dog at a bear? Bear and dog a fight?
I was wondering, like, how the fuck did they get them to
so
do that?
So they got a pug puppy to fight a bear.
And as soon as it mauled
like
it apart?
Took 30 times for the bear to finally run away, but
Holy
it had to kill like 30 fuck. Pug puppies.
Holy fuck.
And then they drowned a bunch of times in the box, apparently.
Oh, my God.
That was, like, my favorite movie as a kid. When I heard that, that fucking bothered me tremendously.
It's fucking horrible.
Yeah.
Holy shit, man.
But, yeah, that's... We're not breaking news here on this story, but...
I mean, to people who never heard that before,
I
you're just connecting
yeah,
the dots.
Yeah, that was, like...
Fuck.
Just think of those Japanese business, man.
That must have been funny with the director, like, sitting there with his hat in his chair. I'm like, oh, the fucking cunt. Fucking another puppy drowns. Like, get him out.
Oh.
That's fucked up. How many? It was a puppy and a cat?
Yeah.
How the fuck they keep that cat fucking
a
not
cat
from roaming off
in the
woods?
Too.
Fuck.
I mean, they would just film them doing random shit.
And then just put a voiceover.
And then a voiceover, like, and Milo was like, what's this over here? And it's just a cat looking at like a dandelion. But
death looks everywhere.
And then they would die constantly.
Oh my God.
Yeah, that was rough news.
I wonder how many Air Buds fucking died, dude. Golden receiver.
Hopefully none.
Golden receiver.
Maybe it got hit in the face. A couple spirals. Maybe they had a kid in there that was lacing it.
Didn't one of them get in trouble for, like, they put, like, a dog in the water for one of those movies? And, like, the dog was in, like, the rapids, and they fished it out, and they were trying to say that was, like, animal abuse.
I mean, might have been Milo and Otis.
No, it was, like, a retriever-looking dog.
Maybe it was Homeward Bound. They had some dog action
movie,
going
dude.
There.
That was a great movie.
Yeah.
Damn, that's fucked up, man.
Yeah.
It's really shitty.
Yeah, didn't Chance get hit with a bunch of porcupine needles? Quills?
Oh, he did.
Yeah, I wonder
animal,
movie,
that's animal abuse.
I wonder about the movie magic on that. There's probably another Japanese dude just a porcupine shoot a dog with the needles.
That's a fucked up, dude. Yeah, dude. Spike him up.
Anyways, what's going on?
Nothing, man. Fucking, I'm just recovering from yesterday. I feel like I like the day after ingesting weed gummies.
Yeah?
I don't like being high. I like the day after when I'm like, oh, nice. I'm like nice and calm.
Normal again?
The whole time it's going on, I'm like, oh, I feel fucking weird. My head feels weird. I hate this. And the next day I wake up and I'm just like, boom, 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 flying.
I hear you.
I mean, there's
times where I'm high where I'm just like, man, I can't wait for this to be over.
Yeah.
I cannot wait for tomorrow and just go to bed, dude. This sucks.
That's most times. But it's a weird thing that, like, It's a weird thing I'm drawn to see how much I can take, like, see how uncomfortable I can get and how much I can steel myself against it. But it's like, yeah, I don't enjoy
it. Dude, you just push your mind.
I'm just pushing my limits, dude. No, I, for the most part, I'm like driving. I just feel incapacitated. I'm driving. I'm like, fuck, dude, this is so fucking bad.
Yeah, well, you're driving while you're intoxicated. That's true. So, yeah, it is. It is.
That true, that. Man.
I slept in my car this weekend.
Oh, shit.
Pretty badass move.
Coming back from...
I was in D.C. on Friday. The D.C. Comedy Festival. Check it out. If you get a chance. But I was driving back from D.C. It was late. And I was like, I'll just take a... I was falling asleep.
Mm-hmm.
And I've done that before. I've fallen asleep and crashed.
You crashed into the fucking...
Which fucking sucks, dude. It sucks so bad. It's so stupid. Like, I was... I don't think I've been that angry in a while. I fucking hit the median. I was on cruise control going 80. And I fell asleep, hit the median, and I was like, holy fuck.
The big cement,
fuck.
The big
yes,
cement thing?
Yes.
Oh. Just even scraping your tire on a curb sounds awful.
Yeah.
When I parallel park, and I'm like, fuck.
Imagine waking up to a crash, a car crash, like a loud fucking, like, douche. I was like, oh, fuck.
Instantly, just be like, oh, I fucking hate myself.
Oh, my God. I would, that was
that's instant cut my life into pieces,
that
dude.
That was. I was so fucking mad. But I could feel myself falling asleep again. I was driving, and I was like, dude, I gotta pull over.
You had flashbacks to the fucking
media,
dude.
I'll never
do
that again. That was so dumb. So I pulled over. I got off this exit, and it was a bunch of hotels. So I was like, nice. I can just, you know, take a quick nap in someone's parking lot.
No harm.
It was like 3 a.m. I was like, this will be a quick nap. I'll set my alarm for 2 hours. Take a 2-hour nap, get back on the road. I woke up at fucking like 11 a.m. Dude, I woke up at 10:30. I slept for like 7 hours in my car. And it was the day it was like 90 degrees. I woke up. It was
so
fucking hot in my car. And then I woke up in a Denny's parking lot. So I was like, fuck it. I'm going to wake up and get some Denny's.
It'd be funny that Denny's was just a mirage you had, dude. You were just sitting in like a Burger King, just like, I'll have a Grand Slam. And they're like, dude, what the fuck are you talking about?
No, I was well rested.
What, you just sleep in your car for 7 hours?
I was well rested, dude. I woke up like, this is nice.
I've never slept in a car and woke up feeling like, no. I wake up and I'm like, oh, where the fuck am I?
I mean, I definitely did that for a second, but it was also like, I mean, that was a long sleep.
That is a long sleep.
That was like,
did you sleep on
your
back? How the fuck do you sleep?
Just
see, I can only sleep on my side. So when I sleep in a car, I lean the seat back and sleep on my side, and I wake up and the whole left side of my body is asleep. And I used to work for a guy where like part of my job was going to construction sites and waiting for deliveries. So I'd be at like a house that was getting built and no one was there, and it would just be me in my car, and like it's coming, it's a 4-hour window, and I would pass the fuck out in my car to some guy just like rapping on my window, and I'd be like, some dude looking at me like, what the fuck are you doing? I'd be like, okay, yeah. And I'd sign the paper, and this guy would be like, what a piece of shit.
Sleeping in your car is a real low point.
On the job. I was like 19. Yeah. I'd be all fucked up the night before and go into work and just be like, sleeping in aluminum.
Yeah, well, imagine being 30, sleeping in a Denny's parking lot on the way back from the DC Comedy Fest. Yeah, I mean, that was a low point. Although I handled it well. I would have thought I would have been a lot more depressed and anxious about that ordeal. But
well, you got a good sleep.
I got a nice sleep, woke up, got some Denny's, took a dump at a Denny's.
You did the right thing.
Got some coffee, some fucking pancakes.
I mean, you are,
it was,
dude,
great.
You don't, you're on the road. Your options are either crash into a fucking median or sleep in a parking lot and eat Denny's, dude.
That's road life, dude.
Exactly.
That's road dogging.
Exactly.
But I did not intend to sleep for 7 hours. That is
fucking funny.
I mean, that was a full sleep.
That's crazy.
Yeah, that was, and the whole time I was just waiting for the Indian that owned that hotel to come out and be like, buddy.
Smack your car.
So, yeah. It's like, wake up.
If that ever happens again, dude, if I ever get in a situation like that, I'm like, there's two guys. Go get them.
All right, where are we at time-wise?
52 minutes.
I know you got a lot of stuff to do today.
Yeah, let's cut it, dude.
You want to call it?
Let's call it.
All right. So, yeah, let's... Oh, April 25th.
Yo,
come
that's
to
a
Helium.
Big one. For a second, I thought it was today, and I'm like, no, that's next
no,
week.
No, it's a week from today.
Ooh,
April 25th,
my God,
Helium,
dude.
Comedy Club.
That's the
Please
big...
come to that.
That's the big dirty, dude.
This weekend, the 21st, I'll be at the Sterling Pig in Media, PA.
Ooh.
Doing two shows there.
Nice.
6 and 9 o'clock.
Nice.
Sterling Pig and Media PA.
Come, get out there,
come
dude.
Through, dude. It'd
be a
but
good time.
More importantly, the 25th, come to Helium.
Fuck yeah.
That's it. Hopefully the audio wasn't too shitty.
I think it's worth it, dude. I'm telling you. I'm going with my gut. I'm going with my gut.
I know our listeners are fucking gay and they're going to complain.
I go with my gut. My gut's never wrong, dude. I go with my gut's never wrong, dude.
All right, good.
I shouldn't be on the air right now, dude.
You shouldn't be on the air. All right. God bless.
Bye.
Praise the Lord, I was born to travel. Feeling like Slash in front of the chapel. I'm lean back with the Les Paul.